The center is funded through Guilford County, but the move toward privatization is part of a statewide mental health reform.
Under review, Medicare and Medicaid coverage at Wake Forest Baptist Health after a young patient is attacked inside her hospital room.
Tonight, the health system is working to come back into compliance. Michelle Kennedy joins us live now with what this all means.
Well, the Centers for Medicare, Medicaid, or CMS placed this legal notice in the Winston-Salem Journal today to alert the public to an involuntary termination of the Medicare-Medicaid agreement with Wake Forest Baptist Health. Now, effective April 24th, if the hospital doesn't fix these compliance issues, Medicare will no longer make payments for patients admitted after April 24th. And for those patients who are coming into the hospital before April 24th, payment will continue for a maximum of 30 days. Now, the notice was issued after Wake Forest Baptist Health alerted the government agency of their own initial internal review of a toddler abuse case on March 27th. It seems security concerns are the root of the problem. 26-year-old Jacob Minton was charged with attempted murder for allegedly assaulting a 2-year-old girl in Brenner Children's Hospital who was being treated for injuries she had previously received at home. The toddler was released from the hospital and is now in the care of social services. It's that incident that has Wake Forest Baptist Health working to improve security in the hospital. They released this statement today. A massive safety and quality review is now underway by more than 20 different teams across the medical center. We have identified opportunities to strengthen safety procedures to better protect the adult and pediatric patients in our care from abuse by others. Hospital officials will submit a letter by this Friday to the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services to prove they're in compliance with CMS guidelines. Here's what Wake Forest Baptist Health plans to do. They've created an enhanced abuse protocol that includes strengthening patient screening, identification, protection, and the investigation and reporting of abuse incidents. This will require training for thousands of hospital employees. If CMS accepts these changes, then care for patients with Medicare and Medicaid will be allowed to continue. If not, the April 24th deadline is looming. That has a lot of folks concerned. Shanice Joyce says her 6-year-old son has asthma and has been seen at Brenner Children's Hospital before. Now she'll take him to Northern Hospital in Mount Airy.
When it comes to your child's life, that's nothing to wait on. I mean, you've got to be right there on top of it. And that's something I'm not going to risk. It's my son's life because of somebody else.
And Wake Forest Baptist Health will submit that formal written response by this Friday. Now, the hospital is confident its improved security plan will be accepted by CMS and patient care will not be affected during this process.